niggas.
Got no faith. That's all it comes down to is faith. Lack of faith, man. Especially the Lord is there with you. You seen his works. They actually seen with their physical eyes the chariots. You know what I'm saying? They seen that. And they was still. That's what blows my mind.
Yeah, still,
they was, you know what I mean? That's crazy. That tells you how powerful Israel had to been to be so proud.
Yeah. Oh, you see the proof?
Yeah.
The proof in the pudding and still don't win it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I tell you, Israel was powerful, man. Israel, they was bad.
Not until calamity comes knocking. Not until that shit comes knocking.
Man, here it is. You walk through the Red Sea, see the sea get split, and you still complaining?
They watched the chariots.
They watched the chariots.
You remember how the chariot came down and sat between them and the Egyptians?
Yeah.
Like overnight?
Yeah, yeah. Hey, let's get that. Exodus 15.
You know what I'm saying? Just sat between them. That's 15.
Yeah, well, I don't know. That's the one where they all get destroyed. Psalms 116, maybe? Oh. The Song of Moses is 15, right? But there's like two songs of Moses, right?
Two songs? I'm saying.
Which one you want it?
Exodus 15?
15 and what?
You can start at the top.
Then sang Moses and the children of Israel this song unto the Lord, and they spoke, saying, I will sing unto the Lord, for he hath triumphed gloriously.
Yep.
True. The horse and his rider hath he thrown unto the sea.
Y'all talking about the Pharaoh and their horses.
The Lord is my strength and song. And he is become my salvation. He is my God, and I will prepare him a habitation.
It's 14.
Oh, 14. Okay. Oh, let's get this real quick, this little part. Yeah, just read the next scripture, and that'd be good.
My Father God, and I will exalt him. The Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name.
All right. Well, you say it's in 14. You want to get that real quick?
Yeah, I
got it. We can finish it up with that.
Well, this is some amazing shit itself, man.
Yeah, but right there, it said the Lord is a man of war. The Lord, well, it really says Yahweh is a man of war. Yahweh is his name.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I just breathe barbarian.
Oh, yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because you know, sometimes, you know, the spirit beyond you to say Lord, because sometimes you just can't be throwing the name around loosely, you know what I mean? The spirit tell you when to bring that name out.
He is not blind.
That's what I'm saying. I'm tripping over the hell.
Damn, it's
you're right. What the hell?
That bun sitting on the corner. You know, that's all on top, checking his cup. He's doing that shadow, bro.
Yeah.
He's doing that shadow.
Man, that's popular.
14.
Israel love to do that.
Hey, hustle. Jacobs. A bunch of Jacobs. Exodus 14, 15. And the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore criest thou unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. But lift thou up thy rod and stretch out thy hand.
Oh, he says, see, we was just talking about the rod, Moses' rod.
And over the sea and divide it.
Yeah.
And the children of Israel shall go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. And I, behold, I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians, and they shall follow them, and I will get me honor upon Pharaoh and upon all his hosts.
He hardened their hearts, meaning there's no such thing as free will. The Lord control everybody, you know what I mean?
Upon his chariots and upon his horsemen. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord, when I have gotten me honor upon Pharaoh, upon his chariots, and upon his horsemen. And the angel of the Most High, which went before the camp of Israel, removed and went behind them, and the pillar of cloud, and the pillar of cloud
there
of the
is.
Cloud went from before the face and stood behind them. And so they watched it from one place to another. They was watching this thing.
They was watching it. That's just crazy. And they still got the nerve to be. I tell you, that's the Lord that put him. That was the Lord that did that to him. That gave him that prideful spirit.
Mm-hmm. And it came between the camp of the Egyptians and the camp of Israel. and it was a cloud and darkness to them, but it gave light by night to these, so that the one came not near the other all the night. So it had to been fucking huge, man. That thing had to been bigger than downtown, man.
Because it did give light to what, over a million people?
Oh, my goodness.
And the scripture tell you that it was over a million, wasn't it?
Downtown, man.
Yeah, it said it was over a million Israelites that came out of there.
Ooh.
It was well over. It tell you the number. It says over a million.
Right.
I could look it up. It's over a million.
You're right. You know it was a multi, because we multiplied and multiplied.
Because that's the reason that whole, the whole thing started with, because the Exodus starts off with eugenics, the Pharaoh practicing eugenics. You know what I mean? Aborting all the babies. Because he said they grow too, they become too many. I don't know if it says the word million.
Now, man, was going on then,
I think the word million is in there, though.
But that chariot sat between the armies of the Egyptians and us. So they couldn't go through it. It was too big to even go around. Plus, they was looking around to go which way to go, but it was too dark that way. It was too dark that way, so they just set their simple asses where they were. It was just too damn big, man. You know? And plus, back then, the nights when it was dark, man, got dark. Weren't no city lights, you know? It was dark back then. Real dark, man. And Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord caused the sea to go back from a by a strong east wind all that night.
A strong east wind. Yeah, you know about the east wind? You reading the scriptures, you'll see that pop up a lot, the east wind.
Mm-hmm. And the four angels blowing control the wind, ain't it? In each four corners of the earth.
Yeah,
usually the east wind symbolizes death, famine, plague. Yeah, getting fucked up.
Well,
you're catching hell.
China, one of their ICBMs is called Deep Death, DEFCON, DEFLON, or some shit like that. DF something, which means east wind.
When you get a chance, do a word search on east wind. You'll see that a lot of scriptures talk about, you know, getting jacked up is getting hit with the east wind.
Yeah, east wind.
I would like when your boy, the book of Jonah. After Jonah got spit out the whale or the fish or whatever he was in, when he got on the land, you know, he was complaining and shit. He was all fucked up. And the Most High hit his ass with the east wind. He was trying to sleep. You know, he couldn't sleep. He had a little shade from the fucking plant. And then the Most High hit him with the east wind. He couldn't get no shade. It's just some funny shit. You know what I mean?
Jonah caused some hell.
Yeah, Jonah. Most High fucked Jonah up, bro.
Listen from the get-go.
What was that? The gourd. He had the gourd, grew up, gave some shade, then it withered away. The east wind hit it and killed it or something. That's a funny book, man. You like? Yeah. I be feeling like Jonah, though, man. You know what I'm saying?
We all examples of Jonah.
Yeah.
We all examples.
Shit, you really be feeling like Job.
That's why Jonah's in the Bible. For an example.
Yeah, it's an example.
Well, that's an example. So, like you said, man, Israel hard-headed and stiff-necked, man.
And Jonah was a prophet. And he was being hard-headed.
Yep. Yep. Let me continue to read some more of this. Where am I at? And made the sea dry land, and the waters were divided, and the children of Israel went into the midst of the sea upon the dry ground. Waters were a wall unto them on the right hand and on the left.
See, the waters was like a wall.
It was like a wall, man. They was walking. Look, man. Can you imagine that, man?
That's gonna be beautiful,
seeing
man.
Seeing fish floating.
Yeah.
You know.
That's when you spent the sea.
Right. Seeing whatever great whales or.
Oh, you probably did see some shit, huh?
Yeah. That'd be on the hook.
That's crazy.
Shit, man. What
the trip. That's gotta be amazing.
But the Egyptologists, Colite them, they teach you that, man, that couldn't happen. You know, they tell you that didn't happen, man. It's just a fairy tale.
Okay, but what the fuck do they believe in? They believe that Osiris got his fucking dick chopped off,
right?
And they worship Osiris, a penisless god.
Yeah.
What kind of bug? They say our shit's bugged out. Look at their shit. They worship a god that doesn't even have a dick.
Right. Like they say that Jonah and the whale couldn't have been real. Which they say that's nonsense.
There has been a case of somebody got swallowed by, what was it, some fish or something?
Yep. Got swallowed by a fish, like a catfish.
Yeah,
There's been rumors in the Amazon. Yeah.
Right here in Ohio.
In the Philippines.
My dad is a fisherman. Man, he said inside of the river, fish bigger than you, bigger than me.
They say that same thing.
Yeah, there's some bugged out shit out here.
Yep.
Because we don't really know what Jonah got swallowed by anyway. Because the scripture just says, it just says dog, D-G, dag, which means fish, but that could be anything. You don't really know what it is, you know what I mean?
That shit was bigger back then anyway.
Yeah, shit was, everything was bigger. There was giants on the earth.
Right.
Check that out.
You know what I mean? Here we go. And the Egyptians pursued and went in after them to the midst of the sea, even all of Pharaoh's horses, his chariots, and his horsemen. And it came to pass that in the morning watch, the Lord looked unto the host of the Egyptians through the pillar of fire and of the cloud, and troubled the host of the Egyptians.
Troubled them. Hey, soon them pillars of fire, they going to trouble their ass again when they come out the sky,
right,
boy.
That's right.
They going to see them chariots.
Damn, motherfucker.
That's going to be beautiful.
Again.
Oh my God.
He's
back.
He went and got a couple of sips and took off their chariot wheels, that they drave them heavily, so that the Egyptians said, let us flee from the face of Israel, for the Lord fighteth for them against the Egyptians.
So the Lord fighting for us.
That's spiritual, how we were talking about that earlier. When the Lord is with us, how we act, yeah, we acting right, you know.
Because a lot of times in the battles, the Lord sent an angel with you.
Yep.
Yeah, he sent an angel out there with Joshua and them.
Maccabees going to that.
And Maccabees. And Joshua too. What's up, bro? You back?
Yeah, I'm
about to. You almost sober now, ain't you?
My bad, man. You know, I ain't sober.
You good, bro. That was the spirit out here earlier.
Yeah, that was bad. Hey,
that's why you got. Well, you let him know that he was the devil.
I
got
waiting.
That's right.
You got praise the Most High.
Yeah, I got his ass. I could have beat his ass.
Looking like, you was looking like Mayweather for a second.
He doing the lean.
He said he one time.
You know?
He said I had it. He really deserved it, though.
That was beautiful.
He was like, what?
I ain't gonna lie, man.
Me again. Oh, yeah.
That was beautiful, man.
Yeah, that's true.
I can't read. I'm being spammed sometimes.
That's good. It's probably almost time to wrap it up, right? Go ahead.
Yeah. It's Hebrews 3. The point is at the bottom. I'm just going to read, Hebrews 3:12.
Oh,
take heed, brethren, lest there be any of you in heart. It's not pretty. Take heed, brethren, lest there be any of you a heart, evil heart of unbelief, and departing from the living God. But exhort one another daily while it is called today, lest any of you be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. For we are made partakers of Yahweh Shai if you hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast unto the end. Why it is.
Oh, that's heavy though. It said the deceitfulness of sin. Yeah, them sins would be lying to you, boy. They'd be like, it's all right, this is one. It ain't going to really hurt nothing. The Lord forgive you.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? You hear the little demon voices. Oh, the Lord will forgive you for that. You know what I mean?
For real.
So you got to curse yourself out.
Like now, man. Demons ain't playing.
You got to curse yourself out, man. You got to
confront you with all kind of wicked shit, man. I'm like, God damn, man. Like, God damn. I mean, I literally had some pussy delivered to me on a platter the other day, man. Bitches kissing all on me and shit, kissing all on me. Like, calm down, bitch, calm down. Can't fuck with me. This bitch had nothing to say. Yeah, me and my boyfriend got in a fight today. That's why I'm up here. Oh, fuck. So get out of here, go on.
That happens all the time, man.
You know what I'm saying? Got my witness, man. This bitch is like, literally. Come on. Took off her before I even knew she had a nigga, man. Took me into the girl's bathroom, took off her shirt, showed me her new titties. I'm like tripping, like damn, man. Right. Like, 2/3 would have been tearing that shit up in the bathroom.
That shit happens all the time. I think I'm about to get me some.
Crazy, man.
And then she tells me that she, she got somebody or, you know what I mean?
Right, you flirting with a girl, you gotta be flirting daily.
Yeah.
And, you got a boyfriend? Yeah. Like, yeah. Bitch. That's
you being tested. You being tested.
That's,
you
know, that's a temptation.
You know what I'm saying? No, knowing that they've been somewhere else, you know what I'm saying? That they ain't gonna come running back. Right. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna be fucked up. You know, none of that disease, none of that bullshit.
Yeah.
Even though I will, you know what I'm saying?
Hey, that's the Lord. That's the Lord's prayer again. Deliver me of what? For temptation.
Yeah, yeah. upheld you.
Well, what is it? How's it go? Lead me not temptation, but deliver me from evil.
Deliver me from evil. Yeah, lead me not into temptation.
Yeah, because that temptation, that's
sign of the angels in control of shit.
That's like that.
That's why I'm be picking up on my cell phone all the time, or picking up the telephone every time it rings, or you know what I'm saying? Even jump on the internet. You know what I mean? Because it's pop up. Like one day I went, I had Facebook, right? I got Facebook, but then I was like, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna go get the tag. You feel me?
Tag. We know about tags.
I swear to God, man. Ain't nobody fucking dudes that jump like women and trying
to
get
that shit. There's a lot of them on there.
I'm thinking it's women and all that shit, you know what I'm saying? But it's really men.
They
shit.
Be hitting you up with messages,
man,
too.
I deleted that shit real quick, bro, man. I deleted my account the same day, bro. Like, man, what the fuck is that?
Tag off the chain, bro.
Tag is where all the hoes is at, though. They're just straight, real whores.
You know that friend requested some shit, you know what I'm talking about? You hit somebody up and they reply back.
Yeah.
And I look at her profile and it said like she had a boyfriend. She like, you know, do a threesome pretty much.
Woo,
I was like,
man,
fuck. She was bad too. I was like, oh man, fuck that.
There be some bad bitches on there.
Yeah.
White girl, fuck that.
I was a dude.
Hey, the way I be on there, every month number Judite women for the most part. And they be going hard on tag, bro.
Yeah, for real.
I mean, they getting around. Baby, that's that site for them lonely nights. You know what I'm saying?
I even screenshot it, bro. It was this bitch. It was a white bitch.
We can make videos on that.
I'm gonna show y'all a picture. And she, the dude, it was my old phone, but the dude was like cursing out in the name of Baal and shit. Like,
oh shit!
Name
wow.
of Baal.
What?
I got it in my old phone. It was crazy. I had to screenshot.
Because a lot of the bitches, you get on their page, on their little profiles, and they got dollar signs in their names.
Yeah.
And they be like, if you ain't, I'm about that money. Pretty much saying you ain't gonna get no pussy unless you give me some money. They be like, if you ain't talking about no money, you ain't talking to me. They be on there getting paid. Them bitches be on there pimping themselves on them websites.
Mm-hmm. They don't need a pimp no more.
Right. Cause like the music industry, you don't need a record deal no more. These hoes don't need a pimp no more.
Right.
Cause they got the internet. Yep.
Yeah. Basically, you have the internet. Want you to put yourself out there. You know what I'm saying? They ain't giving money to the pimps. You know what I'm saying? They giving their money to the dope man.
Oh, yeah. All them bitches, they gone off some shit.
Everybody here doing something. If it ain't weed, if
the main thing is them pills now. Yeah.
Want everything else. The perks, the Xannies.
Yeah, that's the main shit. Yeah, them Xannies, the perks, Oxycontins. You gotta be out your mind.
If I start yelling right now, I got free Xannies and perks. What's
up,
big the crowd again? You know what
damn.
I'm saying? This word free right here, you feel me? Everybody wants to say their ass, you feel me? They're not paying attention.
All right, this is the shit that really gets you high, though.
Perks, y'all be ready to work. You feel me?
The pills we popping really get you high, though. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just speaking a parable like that. You know what I mean? The drug, this right here is the best drug of them all.
That's right. Have your ass up all night. You
yeah.
up all night.
Yeah, you'd be up all night. Your whole house be clean.
Yeah.
Get it? You know what I mean?
It's real. It's crazy, man. You can't explain it, man. It's just bugged out, man. For real, man. I'm telling you, boy.
It's like speaking parables.
I got two more verses. It says, why it is set. It's like, why it's said today. Back in Hebrews 3:15, why it said today, if you will hear this voice, harden not your hearts as in the provocation. For some, when they have heard, did provoke. Howbeit, now all that came out of Egypt by Moses, with whom was he grieved 40 years? Was it not with them that have sinned, whose carcass fell in the wilderness, and to whom swear he that they should not enter into his rest, but to them that believe not? So we see that they could not enter in because of unbelief. One more verse.
Yeah.
Chapter 4. Let us therefore fear, lest that promise being left us of entering into this rest, any of you should seem to come short of it.
And read that. I didn't even get here. I had someone screaming in my ear. I was trying to listen.
Hebrews 4:1. Let us therefore fear, lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it.
Yeah, that's just the shit. You're supposed to be fearing, because here it is, the Lord offering you rest. You're supposed to be fearing the Lord.
Serve the Lord with fear and trembling.
Yeah, with fear and trembling.
He can kick your ass out any moment.
Yeah, any minute.
That's why he said, remember.
It's a horrible thought, man. Just one day you'll take you out of this?
I understand.
That's my worst feeling.
The Lord control everything, man. People be, I think they don't understand that.
Shit, man, you have days you feel like you falling off and shit.
Yeah.
Like you about to...
Actually, if you're not feeling like that, you're probably in the wrong state of mind. There's something wrong with you.
Yeah. Keeps you in the spirit. Keeps you humbly begging, you know. Because you can get all proud and shit. You got to beg, Lord, like, you know, please don't take the spirit off of me.
Yeah, you got to constantly examine yourself.
You wake up sometimes thinking about the Lord's
Cause,
spirit.
Because you know more of the fucked up shit about yourself better than everybody.
Yeah, you're your worst enemy.
Yeah, you right.
You're your worst enemy. When you look in the mirror, you see the main...
You know what you done.
You see the main enemy. You look in that mirror, man.
Yep.
But you know, though, you know what I'm saying? You know when the sin is coming at you, you got to stand and fight it.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I mean? Don't just keep... Like, you know, when you think about smoking an ale, you know what I mean? You can go grab it, you know what I'm saying? But don't do it. Try fight that shit.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm going to try not to do it this trip. You know what I'm saying? I ain't going to go... You know what I'm saying? Like, dude, with all the candy, stolen shit, you know what I'm saying? I ain't going to steal this candy to make it through this day. You feel me?
Yeah.
It's other ways. You know what I'm saying? You got to fight the powers that be. You feel me?
Paul covers that, talking about the flesh, how he wasn't willing, but... The spirit was willing, but his flesh
was. He said he was perfect and everything, but he had one thing that he couldn't stop doing.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, he didn't say what it was. But
you don't know what
you
it
don't
was.
Know. I don't want to know what it was.
That's his business. We all some wicked ass motherfuckers.
We all
continue to.
And every last one of us has got something a little fucked up about him.
But you know what's funny is the Lord know who's in their mind can correct, will acknowledge your wickedness.
Yeah.
Would acknowledge I'm a wicked piece of shit.
Right.
You think Nick, Nate, no motherfuckers gonna do that?
Nah, they gonna say they're perfect.
Yeah, yeah.
They're gonna say there's no sin in me.
Yeah.
But you know, we ain't supposed to sin or nothing like that.
Yeah. But you try not to.
Yeah, man.
There's a difference.
That's
a big difference.
You might be sinning unwillfully. There's something we might not know that we're gonna be sinning on. You know what I mean?
Yep, that too. That too. Yep.
This shit set up that we're gonna go off. Remember that.
Like you said, you might switch the salmon and the eel together. You feel me?
Yeah, right.
You know, you don't even know you're eating a monster.
Oh yeah. All right then, y'all. Shalom. All praises to Yahweh Shem, Yahweh Shalom.